Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about the software process model. First of all, we see the first model, which is the classical model, namely the waterfall model. As the name implies, the water falls from top to bottom. Here this process of this communication, planning, modeling and construction deployment goes down in the stream. So this is the concept of waterfall model. So here, what is communication? Is initially when you are going to develop any model, we are supposed to gather the information about what is being needed between the customer and the developer. So in that sense, they have to communicate a lot in order to get the project initiation project. And then after getting the information gathered, they have to go for the planning. So this planning will consist of the estimating, scheduling and tracking. So estimate the cost, estimate the requirements, is maybe the staff requirements or technology requirements or the cost requirements. So estimate whatever is needed for the whole project, and then we have to make the schedule, how long it will take and where we have to meet the milestone, and all these things will be scheduled and tracking. So once you fix the schedule, we are supposed to track as per the plan, is it going or not. So that is the planning phase. And then once the planning is done, they have to design the model. So that is the analysis and the design. So based on this analysis and the plan, they will define the model of the process so that they can come into some design. That may be a framework, and then what are all the necessary things to get into the framework so that the design will be perfect. So once they model, analyze the whole thing and model something and design, they can write the coding for those models. So that is the construction phase where they can write the coding part. So real, you know, technical point comes play a role here. So here the coding comes into role, and they build the real software, the programming part, and then they'll test the constructed coding. So here, that is the construction part where the coding and testing is done. So testing are many type. So it may be unit testing or integration testing or many other testings are there. So based on the process nature, the testing will be done. So finally, if it is fine, if it is successfully done, it will go for the deployment process. So deployment means delivery, support and feedback. So they will deliver the product in the customer. So in the customer site, and they will give them support for some period, maybe a 2 month or a 2 month period or a 3 month, depending upon the nature of the project. They will support the deployment site, in the deployment site, and then they'll get the feedback from the user. So once they use the project, the product, the customer will be able to give some feedback based upon their experience, how they are able to use the product. So if based on the feedback, naturally it will be, again the process will be reiterated from the top to bottom. So this is called as a waterfall model. It goes from communication till the deployment in a sequence. Okay, so this is the oldest paradigm, is the classical model of process development in software engineering concept. So here the classic life cycle suggests a systematic sequential approach of software development. And the next one is the V model. What is the V model? Is here this just represents the model, the direction the process goes, and the testing how it is done. That is the V shape. Okay, so here this is as usual we have done in the previous thing, requirement modeling, then architectural design, component design and code generation. So this is the natural process. Gather the requirement, analyze the thing, make the framework, then you have to make the coding. What is the component here is make the modules, make different modules, and then you have to, actually what is moduling is making a separate line of code for individual section. So finally they'll have many components, so those components are identified and designed. Then finally it will go for a code generation. So what is code generation is, for each and every module the functions are subroutine or the line of statements are developed and their code is generated. So once the code is generated, it will become an executable part. So that is done. So here the unit testing is done. So once the unit testing is done, and then it will go to the component design. That means they combine the units in order to make the set of the components, the modules. And then after this Parallelly, they'll next go for the integration test when they have developed two or more components. So once they combine those components, that is called as an integration test. So this test will be also checked against the parallel processing. That means once the unit test is done, it is checked with the code generation phase, and then once the component is also checked, and then once the integration test is done, it will check for the component communication between the components, like one module communicate with the other module to get the data or to pass the data. Okay, so that is the integration test. And then finally, once the integration is over, it will go to the architectural design, in the sense that it will just check whether it has come up to the mark of the framework, that is the whole frame of the process. So then that means the whole test can be done. That means the whole frame structure is defined. Now we can do the system testing. Okay, so system testing is the total testing of the software developed. That's the system testing. So it will check against the architecture design also. And then finally, once the system testing is done, it will be given to release to the customer. So that is called as an acceptance testing. So the customer may accept or not, or they may give some feedback. So here, that acceptance is again checked against the requirements modeling, because what the customer were asking for initially, have you done the product up to the customer's requirements or the satisfaction, then only the customer will accept. So these phases goes in the direction of the V. So it is called as an V model. Okay, so it's the variation of a waterfall model, depicts the relationship of quality assurance actions to the actions associated with the communication modeling and early code construction activities. So here the team first moves down left to the side of the V to refine the problem requirements. Once the code is generated, it will move up in the V to get the testing phase done. So this is the V model of software process development. And next one is the incremental model. What is incremental model is, as the name implies, every phase is done to some extent, and it is one set of process. And then after that, delivery is done to the customer up to this level. So the customer may operate those project or product, and they will give some opinion on that. So again, they will go for the same thing will be repeated for the with the feedback given by the customer. So there is incremental too. So here the whole process is done, but it is not fully done. So one section of the process, that means one level will be done, and that is the all the things, the communication, planning, modeling, and then construction and deployment, the whole thing which is in the waterfall model. So this is done for one level, and it is delivered to the customer. So it is under the project calendar time. That means they are fixed, first increment should be released on this particular time. After that, it will be released to the user or the customer. So they will again reiterate this requirement specification, and whatever they wanted to discuss, they will discuss with the developer. So naturally, the second level will be delivered. So likewise, this increment of that is like it's a version of the software released. Okay, so when the increment is done in an incremental basis, again and again, one fine time, the developer and the customer will have the satisfaction of delivering the good product and also the receiving the good product. So this is how the incremental model works. So this is the graph is against the software functionality and the features, and the x-axis was about the project calendar time. So here in this x-axis, it is up to the mark whether it is done as per the schedule, that is the scheduled estimate of the project. So if that is done, how much the quality and the functionality and the features of the developed software. So those components are checked against one increment, and so increment goes on and on, and finally once they come with some satisfaction, the process will be stopped. So that's all the incremental model nature. So here the definition is, when initial requirements are reasonably well defined, but the overall scope of the development of effort precludes a purely linear process, a compelling need to expand a limited set of new functions to a later system release. So initially all the basic things will be done so that a model can be developed, then it will be later released with the new functions and functionalities. It combines elements of linear and the parallel process flows. So what is a linear flow is, sometimes the process can go in a series, that is a linear manner, and sometimes the process can go together in a concurrent manner, that is the parallel process. Okay, so each linear sequence produces deliverable increments of the software. And the first increment is often a core product with many supplementary features. User use it and evaluate it with more modifications to the better meet the needs of the customer. So that's all about the product process software model, and hope it's easy to follow, and thanks for watching.